What's going on, folks? TJ Lauerman, a.k.a. That Sports Gamer here, repping this Orioles jersey. It's number 32 after the great That Sports Gamer. I should get a 10 for Pac-Man Jones now that United we grind. But hey, Team USA won the thing. I feel like we haven't had a bullpen banter in a while. So Team USA won. That's great. MLB 17's out. That's great.
Yeah.
So far, so good-ish. But yeah, it's me. It's me, the D-O-double-G. That Sports Gamer here. I got my man Snaggle J. Chris, how's it going?
It's going pretty good. You know, it's almost seven full days into MLB The Show 17. You're right, we haven't done one of these in a while.
Yeah, last one was like the second to last stream, or before the big stream day.
Yeah, we haven't really done any since the content ended. I think we didn't even cover that big mega stream they did. I think you did your own little thing, and we all just kind of did our own thing. And
I tried to cover it, but you know, life got in the way. So it was
but you know, it's good. I'm again, big ups to USA for pulling down the WBC.
I just noticed
it's an exciting time of year. I mean, if you look at sports IRL, today's actually, you know, opening day. NHL playoffs for those people who watch hockey starts a week from tomorrow.
Yeah, we're here. And we're here for opening day of Bullpen
Banter. We're here. We're here to talk about our first week impressions of MLB The Show 17.
I got great news, though. Let me just tell you. Some more of my season's games just progressed.
Nice.
So now I'm up to 15 hits
In the daily mission?
In my opening day daily mission.
I got them all in one game.
Well, that's because you did a CPU game. I've gotten them all in against people.
See, I got them all in one game, but I'm trying to do the Brewers Epic, so I might as well. I'd try to get kill two birds with one stone. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. So now I'm in the regular season. I've moved up. I mean, so we've talked about. I feel like we don't need to cover like the setup of this game anymore. I think we kind of covered that all.
Yeah, I feel like now we I don't really feel like we should go into basics. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think we need to tell you what ranked seasons is. I feel like that's pretty straightforward. That's the new seasons mode. None of this 1500 and up thing. You start at zero, you work your way up.
Yeah, whatever. I feel like the best way for us maybe to do this is we can kind of go over our impressions. I mean, we do have a list of questions that people have been asking in the Discord. Mm. If you're not in the Discord, you're sorely missing out.
Definitely.
Join in, links in the chat. I mean, if you do have questions, if you want clarifications on certain things that are within our power to answer, you know, feel free to drop it in the chat. I am monitoring it and adding it to the mailbag section that we're going to do later in the show. So if you have questions, feel free to drop them.
I just cranked up some lights. Hopefully it's a little better on my face. I was a little dark there for a minute.
Yeah.
These are the season rewards. We talked about this earlier. They don't stack, so whatever the highest rating you get into is where you get. This is what you want. This one over here. You want this this Goldie.
Yeah.
But yeah, again, so like if you end up in wild card, you don't get the Francisco Liriano, which I think is kind of weird, but that's your decision. A lot of decisions kind of weird that I don't know how I feel about. In this nowadays, but
yeah, I feel like it's been I mean, don't get me wrong, I love the fact that they've added new ways to play Diamond Dynasty. We beat that horse to death when we did the Diamond Dynasty stream review. We were all very excited that there is A, different ways to play Diamond Dynasty, and B, different things to do with your cards. And again, we're going to talk about events later, but that kind of rolls into it. But some of the ways these have been implemented are like, some of them are minor. Like, you know, like again, the seasons thing, I don't know. I feel like, you know, like if I finish a rank above and don't get the Liriano, I feel like what was the point?
Right. Yeah. I feel like that's my main problem with this is I thought this should be,
stacking.
Yeah.
Or at least the cards. Like, I don't want like, don't give me all the XP and all the stubs, but if I finish in wildcard, give me the 6,000 XP, the 1,000 stubs, the 500 tickets, and the Liriano.
Right.
I wish like the card rewards should stack.
Yeah. But you learn you love you something, I think.
Yeah. This whole way they rolled out the daily mission, the time-limited mission for today, where you actually had to go start the mission. Like that, I feel like a lot, judging by the social media response of the first, not looking at the servers, which I'm sure we're going to talk about, social media response to some of these decisions has not been good so far.
And I mean, everybody's happy, except it's just like there's always a tweak on everything. Like you were saying, for this opening day mission here, you had to come in here, hit X to advance it, before the hits started tallying. So if you were like, hey, it's opening day, I'm going to go on, I'm going to go play, I'm going to get those 20 hits, because you had seen this here before, and then you play your game, you got 20 hits, and then you come back here and you're like, oh, we didn't get anything, you'd probably be pretty frustrated.
Yeah, and I feel like I've just like stumbled into completed missions, which is kind of like the Chris Archer program. I kind of forgot that I did something.
I got like two things.
Yeah, I just happened to be clicking on it the other day, and actually, you know what? It's funny. I click on it right now, and I actually have the next program pack unlocked, and had no idea, and have 76 breakout Brandon Guyer. Redeemable, because I'm at 54% and I have no idea how I got there. Like, it's, it's hard. Like, there has been a sentiment that they have done too much and that things are hard to find and things are a little convoluted. And I can kind of see where people are coming from with that.
Yeah, I kind of feel like not every couple games, but I feel like every while I need to like come in through here, come in through the missions, just go through all of them to see if there's anything that's completed.
Yeah. Yeah. I do that pretty much daily.
Like, I didn't know I had two daily missions of my list completed until I actually, so post game, if you want your game to actually count, you need to like go to rest mode or quit out of the application. Or some people said wait 30 seconds. That doesn't seem to work.
Yeah.
But you need to like remove yourself from the server somehow, either by going to rest mode or quitting out of the game.
Right.
So when I came back in, there was a thing on my like that dashboard when you come in that said I had two daily missions completed. That was the only one I knew.
And I see Andy in the chat, and Andy disagrees with the statement I just made. But the thing is put yourselves in the shoes of somebody who this is the first MLB The Show Diamond Dynasty they've played. You'd have no idea what you're doing.
I mean, like, I feel like I'm like, lost in...
Yeah, like, Diamond I mean, you're a four-year Diamond Dynasty veteran. Last year was the first year where I spent a large amount of time in the mode. And I just feel like, I don't feel like it's confusing. Again, I would rather have more content than less. But I just feel like, unless you sit down and map out a very distinct game plan about what you want to do, you can get lost within the mode.
Yeah, that's why I've semi-mapped out what I wanted to do. So, like, I did all those, I ripped all those packs opening day. So now I've gotten almost every 25 team, or every 15 team collection. I need one more pirate, so I just put a buy order in for that. But then I did the Braves 25 man, and I did the Braves full team. Can I see those here? Yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
And that was my thing, right? Yeah, I'm kind of in the same boat, right? Like, I ripped a bunch of packs, and I had almost all the 15-mans. And then I said, well, I'm going to finish the 15-mans so I can get all the rookies and stuff that they had for them, see if some of them have missions. And again, then I started looking at, okay, what team epics do I want to do? Because obviously all of those cards are directly related to the team epics. Some collections are easier to complete than others, i.e. Padres, you know, Twins. So it's like, okay, are those epics worth going after?
Braves really weren't bad.
Yeah, like, I feel like because you have till May 15th to do the seasons part, I feel like I don't even want to play seasons until I spend like a good 2 weeks just doing missions and build up my team.
Yeah, I feel like don't go on until you have, but now that they've built in the modifier for the teams overall, so you're maybe not too bad, but I would say definitely don't go in until you have like at least a silver squad to go online.
Yeah,
and a couple gold guys.
Yeah, and that's the thing is again, like me personally, like I am enjoying the mode. You know, when the servers are allowing it to work, I had a really bad experience at like 9 a.m. this morning, and just it ruined. Like, I didn't want to play the rest of the day.
Hmm.
I mean, like. It's wonderful that you have all this brand new stuff, but if it doesn't work and the servers are how they have been.
Yeah. I mean, we're going to be all over the place probably tonight, but The main thing with the servers has been, like, the first night or two, you could barely connect, right? Was that the main thing, when people couldn't even get on?
It was rough, yeah.
But now you're able to get in. For the most part, I don't think there's been really any problems getting onto the servers or anything.
No.
But now the problem is that when you complete games, they're being sent to the queue, and some are processing, some are not processing. Apparently, most people just have to, like, quit out of the game or go to rest mode to get them to actually process for some reason.
Yeah.
But yeah, I have. They have a lot of timed stuff that becomes an even bigger problem, because you need to get 20 hits. And if you
they're not showing up,
yeah. But like, if you're someone like the majority of these people playing, I would say not only MLB, but I'd also say Diamond Dynasty, aren't on Twitter every day, checking to see what's going on and finding out that, hey, when a game ends, I have to stay on the XP screen, go to rest mode, or quit the game. So there's probably a lot of people,
which is not a fix,
and that's not. Well, I mean. Again, this isn't the only game that's had this. Madden had this. I believe it wasn't the beginning of this year. I think it was last year. Post-game, they would do that, like, they show the scoreboard and, like, everybody running in front. And if you hit X there, your game didn't count.
Yeah.
I don't know how that was a thing, but... if you weren't following us or the MLB The Show account on Twitter or something, you would be trying to do these missions, and nothing would be registering, and you'd probably be pretty pissed. You'd probably stop playing Diamond Dynasty. Like, these are real big problems.
Oh, absolutely. And the thing is, I mean, I'm going to talk about this in two phases. First of all, on the bigger phase, this is yet another troubled launch from MLB The Show. Mm-hmm. Like, this is not like this is the first game. We had the challenge failed issues from last year. You know, this is 4 years in a row, pretty much, where we have had some sort of debacle at launch that has affected the game. Again, if you're a franchise or a Road to the Show player, you've had no problems this week for the most part. I jumped into Diamond Dynasty at 7:30 a.m. Eastern on Tuesday, and I had no problems. I was able to get in, redeem my rewards, rip my packs, you know, complete a bunch of missions, no problem. And then after that, started playing games. Games going to queue, this going to queue, that going to queue. My first BR win didn't show up for almost 24 hours after I got it.
I had to play the Cubs Stronghold. The third time was when I had heard of this quit the game thing. So I had to beat the Cubs Stronghold three times. So that was fun.
Yes. So, like, on the big scale, this is bad. And, you know, like, it's on a small scale, it's like, how many people have really been turned off of Diamond Dynasty altogether in the first week? I'm sure it's probably a very small percentage, but there are probably people that have abandoned this mode and said, you know what, I'm not going to come back to this.
Yeah.
Because, again, I'm having difficulty. I've played these games. They haven't shown up.
Yeah, because everybody that pre-ordered got something, you know, to go open packs, and they can't, for the most part, they probably couldn't have done most of that stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure they could have, but, again, if you're normally a franchise or a Road to the Show guy, and I mean, you got it. Your pre-order was, you got the sponsorship, you got the equipment and all this, and, you know, the packs have the equipment. If you're playing Road to the Show and they have sponsorship stuff, if you're playing franchise, you know, you want to open those packs. You were probably having problems. And, again, if you're not on social media,
yeah,
I mean, you're kind of left out in the cold.
Yeah, and that's D. Buono in the chat is saying that he's been trying to help people and tell them, and he had this one kid ask him. He said he's played 20 games in the same square and none of them have counted. Like, he had no idea about the queue or what it was and what it was going to and how it was affecting his game. And, like, it's just, the thing is, every time they roll out a Band-Aid, like waiting at the screen for 30 seconds or, you know, this or that, they're Band-Aid fixes. They don't make anybody happy. They're not permanent solutions.
I mean, those aren't even coming from them. Those are just, I guess, the things that we as a community have figured out that actually work.
Yeah, But they give them legitimacy. Like, when Tips tweets that stuff out, it makes it a legitimate quote-unquote fix, when we all know it's really not a legitimate fix. It's just what they've decided to make work. It's been very disappointing from a standpoint of having to deal with this the way we've had to deal with it yet again.
Yeah, hopefully in the next couple of days this will all clear itself out. Also, I found a bug with Ryan Butcher, I believe is his last name.
Yes,
Padres closer. Even in the stretch, he's stuck in his windup rotation or his windup animation. So if you have a guy with any kind of speed, you can. I had flashback Ichiro in BR. I stole second base standing up. Actually, Ichiro slowed down as he got to second base before Butcher even released the pitch.
Oh, nice.
So that was pretty good. And that game, also, I think I sacrificed fly Ichiro to third. And then because the bug was so bad, I stole home to win the game.
Ah, yes, which I've seen. I've seen that.
Also, I'm playing a game right now.
I see that as well.
For the mission.
I see. I'm watching the delayed version that I get to see.
So that's. I think that's enough of the beating on the
servers. Yes. We don't want to beat a dead horse with the servers. I mean, they're bad. You know, it's not good. They're going to get fixed. Hopefully. We're probably going to get packs out of it.
I would hope so. Especially, it's one thing. I think the bigger problem is that there's a lot more... in Diamond Dynasty, they've put a lot more time-limited stuff.
Yeah.
You know, so like... still looking for our first hit in the ball game. Yes, like this opening day thing. So there's people that aren't going to know that they have to go in. That A, aren't going to know they have to go in and advance that. And B, aren't going to know that they had to quit out after at the XP screen to get their credit.
Yeah.
So, But on the bright side, the gameplay
is
no joke the best it's ever been in any baseball video game ever.
Yeah, I would almost say 100%. Any sports game. The plan coming into this was we want to talk about the servers and be done with it, because we really want to talk about how glowing this game is when you get on the field and play. The attention, it's the same old adage, right? It was when on the last generation of consoles, to try to compare it to something that I've had to experience, the last generation of consoles, the NHL series was probably the best sports game series on a continual yearly basis in terms of gameplay.
What was it, NHL 09 is when they started?
And NHL 09 through like 12. Yeah, they were all game of the year sports game contenders every single year. And you always wondered, what are they going to be able to do next year to make it better? And that's kind of where we've gotten with MLB The Show and its gameplay is, how are they going to make it better? Because the gameplay in 16 was very, very good. You know, sure, there was issues with bunt cheese and you know, which is a minor issue, but you know, that's something that we've had to deal with along the way. But it's like everything that they've added from a gameplay standpoint, it just works. It works so well, from the ball physics to the animations to the lighting to, you know, the humanity AI. It all just melds together. And I can tell you, as a baseball player with, you know, 25 years of experience, this is as close as they're ever going to get to replicating real baseball.
Yeah, that new ball physics, like, it's mind-boggling sometimes. I had one in honor of WrestleMania. I did a little Bullpen Banter pregame tonight. I hit one, I want to say it was Evan Gattis or someone. And it was like, dude busted me inside. And I somehow made contact. I shot it over the shortstop's head, and it had some crazy spin on it that, like, went over the shortstop and then, like, cut it between the two outfielders, and I was able to get a double out of it.
Yeah, it's insane. Like, I feel like one thing that has made a huge difference to go along with, and this maybe is just how I feel, this may not actually be factual, but to go along with the way the ball moves, I feel like the speed of the outfielders has been lowered just a hair to allow those slicing balls to fall in. Like, I find bloop hits are a fair bit more frequent. Balls that fall in front of the outfielders, I feel like when you're playing franchise or well, any mode really, I feel like you can actually make a difference with defensive shifts. Mm-hmm. I've seen Millennium do it on his franchise streams several times in the past week where he's used shifts to his advantage and it's actually paid off, that the hitters actually will hit to their tendencies and things of that nature. Like, I just feel like everything works so well together to make it actual baseball.
And I would definitely not be playing guys out of position.
Oh, no. And, yeah, that was the other thing.
I say that with Edwin Encarnacion playing third base right now, but it's a secondary position, and, you know, it counts.
Defense, and that's the other thing. Defense is so important this year. Mm-hmm. It's like, it's ludicrous. Like, you make bad decisions with where you put guys, or you make bad decisions in the field, and it's going to hurt you. It may not hurt you the first game, may not hurt you the second game, but it's going to hurt you eventually.
Get yourself a dope shortstop and a dope second baseman.
Yeah.
Even if they can't slug it out, just have them to cover around. Oh. We just had a great example of sweet, sweet ball physics. Almost there.
Well, and that's the thing. Yankees is here. He's excited that another season of Bullpen Banter is back.
See, okay. I mean, I know I want you to keep talking, but the hit that I literally just had was like the most perfect example of something that had not been in the game for a while. Dallas Keuchel went oppo looper over the infield, and it fell right in front of the left fielder charging and going to his right.
I just saw that happen. Like, again, you would never see that before.
And I feel like there's again, like you said, the guys feel the outfield seems like they're a little faster, or not
slower
inside the park. Yeah, the outfield feels like a little slower. So I feel like your opportunity to hit balls into gaps that actually fall and aren't like one hop and caught that are getting first base hits are a lot higher this year.
Yeah, and I feel like what that has done with the outfielder speed is it makes reaction a much more important attribute for your players.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, but previously we usually would just talk about, you know, arm strength and fielding.
Yep.
You know, are they going to drop a routine ball and can they gun a guy out from, you know, 2 feet from the wall at third base?
Yeah.
That was what we were reaction is important.
Yeah, you definitely want a guy with a good combo of all three.
Yeah.
Speed, reaction, and fielding.
I have watched a lot of streams this week of people, you know, just, you know, random MLB The Show streamers just to see how they're handling the game. And if I've seen a lot of people who have come into setting their lineup with a very 2016 mentality and they've struggled. They've had issues. They're, you know, putting Mark Trumbo in the outfield. Yes, he's got massive power, but he's a huge liability.
And also that's part something, I don't know if I don't know if auto-generate rosters is, like, messed up or something, but it's got guys playing all over the place. It at one point had me having Trumbo in right field and Chris Davis playing third.
Yeah,
I could not allow that to happen because that was going to be a problem. Chris Davis, even the couple games I did have Chris Davis play, it led to many, many issues.
Yeah, and I agree with Dee Bono who said, you know, again, a lot of us thought ball physics was going to be, like, awesome. I mean, I'm pretty sure we were all that ball physics was probably the top of our list of things that we were excited to see. But having now been able to play the game, it far better than what my expectations were.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be nice and something cool to look at every once in a while. But it's like so key to the game. Like it's not even.
Oh,
absolutely. It's changed it completely. And it's made, absolutely. And again, it's made, I mean, I think it's made, definitely having guys with good contact, good vision at the plate matter even more. It's made having quality defense matter even more. And I think the biggest thing that's changed, and it's kind of one of the things that we called as we started seeing some of this stuff roll out for, Dallas Keuchel just got hurt. But yeah, one of the things we were talking about was, is this ball physics thing going to be something that makes finesse pitchers more important? Everybody got in a big all up in arms last year when he had that Cliff Lee card come out. Great. Really. Dallas Keuchel gets hurt, and the first pitch with Joe Blanton is a home run.
Oh, no.
Was he having a no-hitter until that point? Probably. No, there was no no-hitter. Okay. Yeah, so I feel like David Price. I have David Price, Dallas Keuchel, and a couple other guys. But guys that aren't hitting 95, 96, which last year, if you weren't throwing 95, 96, you weren't getting strikeouts.
Yeah.
You probably just weren't effective because you had to pitch to contact because you weren't going to be able to strike out guys with how foul balls worked last year. And they were just useless. Like, I really love that the idea of that Cliff Lee card that came out late last season.
Yeah.
And that card right now would be pretty nasty to have. I mean, I kind of have it in Keuchel and David Price, but that card could not play last year because you could not put away hitters with him. And this year,
they would just foul off and foul off and foul off until you finally left something over the plate, and then they would make you pay.
Yep.
You know, especially against better hitters. Yeah, I feel like you can be more. You can lean more in the direction of people you pitch well with.
Yeah.
You know, I'm still tinkering around with my rotation, you know, again, as my collections are evolving and I'm picking up cards here and there. You know, and I mean, I do have some power guys. I have Cole. I have Garrett Richards still.
But even Cole has a lot of off-speed stuff that you definitely want to be using. Yeah.
And I feel like someone like Garrett Richards, who, you know, was a silver stud last year, based solely on his velocity, this year he's still a stud because not only does he have the velocity, but he also, his pitches move. His two-seamer is 96 with movement. So it's like, you know, velocity guys with, it's made them better as well.
Yeah.
Like it has changed how you have to look at your pitching rotation. You can keep, you know, slower, clunkier guys who have good movement, and you can get away with it because of the ball physics.
That I don't know how hard he throws. That flashback Trevor Cahill might be one of my favorite bronze players this year.
Yeah, he does 79. He does not throw very hard.
He's a 79, but his pitches, I don't think there's a pitch he has that if you put it in the middle of the plate, they would sit there.
Yeah.
Except maybe his fastball? And I wonder about that.
Yeah, no. Oh! He's been...
Joe Blanton.
He's been good.
Yeah, he's pretty crazy. Highly recommend that card for the event coming up.
Yeah. I used Steven Wright. If Detroit is still in the chat, he can gladly attest to how OP Steven Wright is.
And I know players are OP again.
Because he's, I mean, the knuckleball moves everywhere. You can't square it up. Have I used the Steve yet for completing the Palmer mission? Yes, I have. And I love him. The 85 Dave Steve. Oh, baby. Oh, baby.
See, I mean, great example. I lit up that home run with Joe Bland, and now I'm just throwing everything at the bottom of the zone, and they're just grounding everything out. He's got a nasty sinker and slider. What do we want to talk about before we get into that event stuff?
So, I mean,
I played a little bit of Road. I mean, we can talk about other stuff other than 99.
Yeah,
I played a little bit of Road.
Absolutely.
I think I'm like a month in ish.
Right.
Didn't do too much. But so far, haven't had any problems with my team. I feel like I've been playing it as I would play it, I assume, if I was a real prospect.
Right.
So I've been pretty much like, thanks. Appreciate that a lot. I haven't really been going any jerky. I haven't been jerky or giving them lip whenever they say anything. So I've played it pretty straight up. Have you tried doing anything like getting mad at the team that drafted you or anything?
I literally played Road to the Show until like two games into the season. I just wanted to give it a try and see, you know, I did use some of the cockier answers. And for some reason, even though I was the highest overall rated position player on the team, I was batting eighth. I don't know if that had, like, the coach didn't come and tell me that had anything to do with it, but I was hitting eighth in my first double A game. So, you know, it didn't specifically say that was part of it. But I haven't spent a whole lot of time in the mode. I've been primarily playing franchise for the last couple of days.
How's that? You did a community franchise, right?
Yes, we did the first community franchise stream tonight. We lost 3-0 to the Orioles. Gosman ripped me apart. The franchise is very similar to last year. We did use the quick manage is very, very nice.
Oh, yeah.
You can do a quick manage game in about, like, you could do it in 60 seconds if you wanted.
Nice. And have you been hopping in and doing stuff, or
I did not hop in. Bit of a time crunch tonight to try to get here for this. So we were just trying to quick manage some games.
We had to get in your way.
No, that's okay. I just was saying, you know. But I didn't jump in just yet. The MLB Network presentation is fantastic. It adds a lot to the mode. It makes opening day games feel like opening day games, like with the different overlays and the different music, and like it does add something to the franchise mode. But again, it on like the surface, it's a very similar mode. But again, with the way ratings are reflected in the gameplay now, with, you know, it makes managing your franchise vastly different. For sure.
Yeah, I have not started a franchise.
I've got two on the go right now.
I just put my game into rest mode because I won. I think I quit.
Oh, okay. Rest mode.
Alex Bregman, Detroit sports guy, says he started a franchise with the Astros since our Bullpen Banter online franchise was canceled. And Alex Bregman is beastly. Alex Bregman, super cheap in Diamond Dynasty right now. I'd highly recommend you go get a bunch of them. He plays third, short, left. Does he play right and second and maybe first base? Dude plays everywhere. Good overall, like across the board. And he's definitely going to be on the come up.
Yeah. And Alex Bregman, if you don't have 5 Alex Bregman cards, you're doing it wrong. Mm-hmm. Dude's 1 point away from gold. One point away from silver.
He'll be gold.
And I feel like if he goes out and catches fire, I mean, he's got diamond potential. He's only 11 points away from diamond. And, you know, we haven't had any roster updates yet. So, I mean, he does have a outside shot of becoming a diamond.
I just realized you cannot see. Can you see game history?
See what?
Your game history? Okay,
you can. Yeah, go to your team, your squad page. And it's on the right.
Mm-mm.
Game history.
All right. Well, my game, I went to rest mode and came back in, and apparently that did not do the trick.
But yeah, if Alex Bregman's not on your event team, you're definitely doing something wrong.
Yeah. So you want to talk about the event? Give me a
We can talk about the event.
Give me the hotness on the event. Or I'll pull it up on
Yeah, you can pull it up. I can kind of lead into it a little bit.
Pull it up right here.
So one of the big Diamond Dynasty features, guys, is you guys all know they were going to be running events. So these are going to be time-limited, you know, special things where you can earn special rewards. Rewards for total wins, rewards for winning streaks. The first event will start tomorrow, and it is in... Copying the first Bullpen Banter tournament fashion, it is bronze and common cards only. Kicks off at 3 p.m. Eastern time tomorrow, and you have literally exactly 7 days to compete in said event.
There are three inning games on All-Star difficulty. There's no fee to enter. Not like with BR where you need to pay the 1,500 coins every time.
Yep.
Like you said, 79 overall or lower. When you go into the event screen, you'll be able to see just the apparently I unlocked some of the stuff in the Arch Rookie program.
Oh, nice.
I had no idea.
Yeah. So when you go in to set up the event, it'll only show you applicable cards that you can use in the event. You're allowed to play once you lose 2 games, a la BR. You can then resubmit a separate lineup and start over with no fee. The top prizes are for 80 total wins and a 10-game winning streak. Those are the top rewards. And I think that is not even going to sugarcoat it. Absolutely ludicrous that you have to win 80 games in a week.
Yeah, I think the streak one is fine. You see here, if you get a 4-game win streak, you get a bronze Live Series card. 6-game win streak is a silver live series card. 8-game win streak is a gold live series card. And a 10-game win streak is legend Jim Rice. I think that's fine.
Yeah.
I would kind of not like to see the live series stuff tied in. Maybe leave the live series gold, but I think the silvers and the bronzes should probably just be any card.
Agreed.
But yeah, these cumulative winner awards, needing 80 wins to get All-Star Jason Giambi. Okay. I did some math. I'll do it again now just to make sure I have my math correct. How long would you say a BR game takes you from search to finish? If it was only, and let's just say search to finish, it's only 3 innings, nothing crazy.
20 minutes.
The answer is you're correct. It's 20 minutes. Cause sometimes I'll set the recording for it and it'll be about 20 minutes. Yeah. So 80 wins times 20 minutes is 1600 minutes.
Yeah. You get 3 an hour. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's a lot of work.
Yeah. You need to essentially play. If you don't lose, go into extra innings or anything, you essentially need to put in 4 hours a day.
Yeah, that's absolutely ridiculous.
I don't have words for that. I'm at a loss for words because, like, don't get me wrong, I freaking love this game, but I would literally need to spend every waking moment that I am not at work or taking care of my son before he goes to bed.
Yeah. And also, that's time where you can't be playing BR. Mm-hmm. You can't be doing seasons.
Yep.
It's like, I feel like they've made you... Now, again, seasons is it's May 15th, right? So it's a 6-week thing, pretty much.
But I think there's going to be events every week, right?
Yeah. So it's like, I'm like, I don't... Like, how ludicrous this is. If that was 2 weeks, I would still be complaining that it's not long enough. Mm-hmm.
So here's what happened initially, because I want to say the first one that they showed might have been for a month. Like when they were showing it on the stream, that Wild West one.
Yeah.
Was that up for a month?
I thought the first one they showed was May 15th.
Yeah. Well, that's the season thing. So I wonder if they just copied that over for that part. But yeah, I thought it was going to be a month for these. And then when I heard it was 80 wins, I was like, 80 wins over a month. I'm like, you know, that's like 2 a day. I'm like, that's kind of a lot. Yeah. Now knowing I need 12 a day seems a little ridiculous. And again, that's 20 minutes start to finish, a 3-inning game, assuming nothing happens. Also, assuming the servers work and you get credit for every single one of those wins. I mean, and first off, we all know these 3-inning games are not going to take 20 minutes because half of them are going to go to extra innings.
Yeah. So, and I mean, to be realistic, even if you were exceptional at MLB The Show 17, mm-hmm. in all likelihood, you're probably going to lose 10 or 15 games.
Yeah, I don't think anybody's going 80-0. You're probably playing 100 games to get the 80 wins.
Yeah. I mean, I am in online play undefeated so far this year. There's not a chance in heck I'm winning 80 games in a row.
For games that count, I am undefeated, so I'm pretty excited.
There you go. That's the way to have it. But like I don't understand the thought process of rolling this out like that. I really don't.
Yeah. I definitely thought this was going to be a month.
Yeah.
And then I thought a month I'd be like, okay, that's a lot, but it's still good.
Yeah.
Like I could probably do 2 a night. Maybe on the weekend I'll catch up a little bit. But yeah, I'm lucky on a good night to not get yelled at. I can play from 9 to 1, which is 4 hours.
Yeah. And like during, like in that time, like, see, I'm thinking of it from like a standpoint. Let's say I did it 7 days a week, 4 hours a day. Mm-hmm. I'm probably going to stream. I have a channel and a community that will want to see me stream. That takes additional time because you're interacting with chat. You know, you're doing this, you're doing that. Like, I don't understand how these people who, like, have they never played their own game? I don't, there is not one part of me that understands this at all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, hold on. Literally right now, my one game, my game processed. I'm up to a 295 rating. Great news. Great news, everybody. Am I almost to the next level?
So here's the question I'll pose to you. Knowing what has to go into it, are you going to take part in the events at all?
I will run. I will probably do a run. Try to get that 10 in a row. But when I lose, I'm probably going to be done. I don't think I'm going to keep re-upping because I don't see the value in it. Because where is it? Can we go back? Let me go back to this real quick. Let's just say I run one. I get. What do you think would be a normal week's worth of this? Maybe 20 wins and I don't know, like 3 6 game streaks, maybe an 8 game streak.
Well, given the fact that the rewards are golds, like that doesn't get me excited for the mode either.
I feel like a 6 game win streak's okay, an 8 game win streak. I mean, I don't really get 8 game win streaks in BR. So I don't.
I've never won 8 games in BR.
I don't think a gold. I feel like if I tried, I would probably maybe get an 8 game win streak, maybe 2 6 game win streaks, which would be a gold, 2 silvers, and a bronze for the 20 cumulative win.
I think I would,
and plus you would get all the post game rewards, which probably wouldn't be much because of the. Because they're short games and stuff.
Right.
I just don't see the value in this currently.
Yeah.
That's why I'm trying to be vocal about it. I don't want to seem like a dick about it, but I want me and other people that also agree that this is a little ridiculous. Like if this was 60 wins got you Jason Giambi, I'd still think it's a little crazy, but more attainable. And I probably wouldn't be as mad, but I think we need, especially for this year with all the changes that they've done, I think we need to be very vocal and not just this is really stupid, but we need to be very specific about what is wrong with the things and what we think would be better ways to do them and not just screaming at them. I think we need to go in today. I said, I like these streak bonuses. I think these are good. I think we should lower the cumulative win stuff, because if it's just a week, I don't think this is enough time for a normal person, or even look, I'm not going to consider myself normal. I'm going to play this game nonstop for the next week, but this just is not something that is. I don't think you can put 80 wins into this and have any semblance of a life or literally do anything else in the game for a week.
We've had this discussion before about trying to dumb down Diamond Dynasty so that everybody can have all the best cards, right? Like for the person that plays 8 hours a day to the person that plays 8 hours a week. I don't want Diamond Dynasty to be like that. I don't want this to be like, hey, get 5 wins this week and you get this Giambi, right? I want it to be a challenge, but I don't want it to be impossible. I look at that and I feel like getting 80 wins this week for me personally is absolutely not going to happen, and there's zero point in me trying. Now, the Jim Rice is a fantastic card. He has 82 and 98 contacts, 65 and 81 power.
It's nice.
His defense is not terrible.
Mm-hmm.
He's a nice card. So I might make a run or two to try to get the 10 wins, but I am not dedicating 30 hours of my week to try to pick up 80 wins to get a gold Jason Giambi. It's not happening.
Yeah, I feel like even the 20 and the 40 wins, that's just not enough.
Yeah, 20 wins. You have to win 20 games to get a bronze card.
Can I just do the math real quick? Let's say, what's it, 20 times 20? It's 400 minutes?
Yeah.
Is almost an hour. That's an hour a night. I mean, that's okay for a bronze.
Or you can go in and what is it? You can exchange 3 commons for a bronze?
Or
in the extreme conditions?
Or you could go buy a bronze for, hold on, did I just...
for 20 stubs?
Let me go check, because I would like to know how many. Where do I go? Shop?
Yeah, well, I can tell you I was buying bronzes today for between 20 and 30 stubs on the regular, trying to complete 25-man collections.
Yep.
I bought a couple for 9 stubs.
Oh, those people are dumb, because quick sell of a bronze is 10 or 12. So I just bought Jared Hughes for 30 stubs. And you know what that does for me? Gets me my elusive missing 15-team collection.
Nice. There you go. I wouldn't spend that much time playing if the reward was Jesus Christ and he was a Ruby 120 rating, sick power numbers, and a Machado-esque glove.
Yeah, I was saying, like, I literally don't know what card would even get me to think about spending that much time to do something.
And that will be tomorrow's question of the day in the bullpen banter. What card exists?
Yeah.
Like, I feel like...
Or even doesn't exist. Like, make up something. Let me know. Because...
Yeah.
I can't think of a card.
I feel like if it was Mike Trout, I probably still wouldn't do it. Like, not even kidding.
No, yeah, definitely.
Because I know I can't get there. That's the thing. I don't have the time. And the thing is, the fact... Like, again, these guys know what's going to have to go into winning this. They're not dumb. That's why I think maybe the rewards...
If it had more vision. Yeah. If it had, like, 80 vision, then I'd be in. But.
So I think the reason why the rewards are gold is because they don't want to hear people complain next week that 3 people got 80 wins and that the mode is stacked towards people who play all day long.
Because I've
seen those comments already.
Yeah, I want to see what kind of results they get out of this. I doubt we're going to find out.
Oh, we're never going to. They're never.
I would love to know what kind of results we get out of it. That's an A's.
The best thing that we could have happen is not a single person reach 80 wins.
I mean, that would be key.
That would be like, don't even try. Don't even play events.
Yeah,
try to get the Jim Rice. You want to try to get Jim Rice? Go ahead. I'm going to take one crack at Jim Rice. But I feel like my time in Diamond Dynasty right now is better spent trying to build up my squad by completing collections and competing in ranked seasons. Because ranked seasons, a lot of people have been speculating that it only really takes, you know, 25 to 30 wins to get to the top rank. And you get a 97 Goldschmidt.
I'm trying to. So I saw somebody on Twitter said this is like an event for kids. I'm trying to think, like, when I was in high school, maybe if I didn't play baseball, I could have done it, maybe. But, like, again, for, like, high school, it was like I would get home from baseball at like 6, showering at dinner and stuff, so I'd maybe get on at 8:30.
Yeah,
8:30, and then play till midnight-ish.
I don't think there's a point in my life where I ever would have been able to do this.
Oh, there's definitely a point. It was called my sophomore year of college when I literally did not care,
and I was playing so
much roller hockey. But then I was playing roller hockey and a lot of NHL, like ESPN NHL hockey or whatever it was called.
Right. I did a true 162 in MVP baseball over March break. In 2003.
Yes. Rebecca in the chat says she doesn't do anything and she's in high school and she cannot play this game 4 hours a day.
Yeah, it's rough. I just feel like again,
love the game. I don't want it to make it sound like we hate this game because
but like you said, if you go on social media and you are constructive with your feedback, the one thing that we have seen over time is that Sony San Diego can be receptive to feedback.
Yeah, and they are listening, and they have tips now as part of this new live team that they put together. And I really think they're going to listen. So I would say, don't go out there and just yelling at them, but constructive criticism and feedback is definitely hugely helpful. Hit him up at MLB The Show on Twitter, at MLB The Show _tips.
Yeah.
And definitely the forums on theshownation.com. Also, on theshownation.com, when you sign into PlayStation, make sure you set up your 2-factor authentication. Huge.
Agreed.
That's huge.
How many wins did it take you to get to that 295 rating?
Like six, five or six, probably.
You're a third of the way there.
Yeah, but I don't know how that works.
Yeah, like does the rating get smaller and smaller as you go up the ladder?
I would assume so, because I don't think they want everybody having 96 mixture or 96 Paul Goldschmidt. So
I want that Goldie bad. No sense in playing it unless you're going to get the Goldie.
Let me see. Where did I put that link? I have made the squad that I will be running in this bronze event. Not a huge fan of the event, but I did build a team for it. I'm pretty excited.
Well, because we're here in the Bullpen Banter, and we want to give the people who may enjoy these events, not that any of them are here.
I think there are people. I mean, there'll be people in here that win gold players. I will say that.
Yeah.
They're going to win their gold players. It's going to be great. Why did my link not work? Holdy. Because I clicked the wrong one. That's why.
Okay.
I feel this bronze squad that I've put together is well worth taking a shot at this event with.
Okay.
Using our good friends at daddyleagues.com. Link in the chat to the squad that you can look at. So for my starting rotation, I've got 70... I can't see. This is too small. I've got 79 Jason Hamill. That's the live series card. Good stuff. I have the 79 Scott Kazmir. He's got a sinker, slider, cut, curve, all the good stuff there. The Trevor Cahill that we talked about earlier, that's the flashback, the 78. He's got a whole bunch of pitches that break everywhere. I think he's got a sinker. Is he like sinker, slider, curve, something crazy? I don't think I can click the cards here anymore, right? Yeah, he's good. What up? Jay Happ, your boy. I know you're a big Blue Jays fan. Ian Kennedy. What was it? Hamill, Kazmir, Happ, Kennedy all have 60-plus hits per nine, 60-plus Ks per nine. And I want to say 60-plus walks per nine as well. I felt like that was something that I wanted to make sure that all these guys have good stats and that kind of stuff. Thoughts? What other sort of starting pitchers would you use? Snaggle J. Hello. Good eye. I think Snaggle J just died. Hold on. Let's get him back. Snaggle J decided to take the jacket off, put the hat down, put the gloves on the ground, just walk out of here like the Undertaker, right off into the sunset. There was a big pop, and now he can't talk. I wonder if his microphone exploded. So hopefully we'll get him back. But yeah, those are my starting pitchers. I like those guys. If you have any more suggestions, I'd love to hear them. They're a decent rotation. For the bullpen, these guys all have, I believe it's 80 plus hits per nine and 80 plus walks per nine, or 80 plus hits and 80 plus Ks per nine. That was kind of the... Hey, there you go.
Hello.
I hear you.
Nope.
I hear you.
What the heck is going on here?
I assume the chat hears you, too.
Oh.
Interesting.
What happened?
I hear you. He probably, like, hit mute on something.
Weird, yeah. I can hear... I can't hear you, but...
I bet he muted his
headphones. I also can't hear the stream.
I bet he muted his headphones.
No.
He did. I feel it. Yep, that was it. Nope. Okay. Interesting. Well, Yeah, so bullpen, Zach Duke, Bruce Rondon, Boxberger, Seacrest, the Yankee Clipper, Antonio Bastardo, and Carl Edwards Jr. I think Carl Edwards Jr. has like 90 Ks per nine and 90, or it's like 94 Ks per nine and 88 or 90 walks per nine, or hits per nine, so he's going to be pretty nasty.
Okay, we're back.
And we're back. Welcome back.
I said unplug my mic from the USB and plug it back in. Apparently, I don't know. I was opening Daddy Leagues, and there was a gigantic pop in my ear, and then everything went deaf. Hey,
super dope, deaf, and even outrageous.
I love your team, though. It's a great team.
Thank you. You like the J-Hap in there? Because I know you're a big fan.
J-Hap is on my bronze squad as well. Oh, nice. His control can be a little wonky from time to time, but he's hard to find that good of stuff with a lefty and the bronze tier.
Yeah. I don't know if you heard the bullpen, Zach Duke, Bruce Rondon, Brad Boxberger, Kevin Seagrist, Tyler Clippard, Antonio Bastardo, and Carl Edwards Jr. I believe they all have 80-plus hits per nine and 80-plus walks per nine, or Ks per nine, one of the two.
Yeah, no, I like that bullpen. I feel like there's a lot of good, not a lot of good bullpen options, but there are.
Yeah, I think like 77 to 79, there's a lot of middle-of-the-road guys.
Yeah, like I feel like with starters, there's only so many you can go with. I know Michael Wacha is a very popular one. I can't remember if you had him on yours or not.
I did not. He was very close to making the list. He only had four pitches, I think, was the thing that
yeah, got off. Drew Smiley's probably a popular one as well for a lot of people. I do like the Kazmir.
I like him because he has the sinker on Kazmir.
Yeah. Steven Wright, if you want to go with the knuckler, Steven Wright is in the conversation at a 78. Mm-hmm.
You can throw a bunch of knucklers because I want to say Dickey's in there.
Dickey's in there as well.
Gamboa, yeah. I believe, is common. So yep. You can run at least three.
One guy I've had some success with as well at starter is Carlos Rodon, who's a 77.
You heard the bad news today?
What's
out
that?
For like 6 to 8 weeks.
Well, that's not surprising, though. Yeah. That's the White Sox for you. Yeah. That's usually how they roll. My reliever core is pretty different.
Ooh, Liriano, a recommendation of Liriano from the chat. I think he was close to making my list.
I don't like Liriano's pitch mix, though, is the problem. Two fastballs, a slider, and a changeup. I know he's got good break, and he's got some pretty good velocity, but not a huge fan of his pitch mix.
He's a starting pitching version of the rookie Chris Sale, what you're saying.
Pretty much. Okay. Yeah, like guys in the bullpen that I like, again, bullpen, there's a lot of guys in that. I mean, there's 16 guys that are just 79. Mm-hmm. I like Keon Aquila from Texas. Uh-huh. Again, throws a lot of gas. Felipe Rivero, if you're looking for a lefty reliever from Pittsburgh.
Yep, he's actually been on my squad, like regular squad in the game, as my lefty arm until I pulled Jerry Blevins yesterday.
Yeah, if you like those gimmicky guys, Joe Smith. Joe Smith is there as well.
Sidearm action.
Yeah, Justin Wilson, again, another lefty, throws a lot of gas. Joaquin Soria is always a favorite because you can always mess people up with that 70 mile an hour curveball.
What's K-Rod?
K-Rod is
you continue.
I think he's an 80.
Ooh. Hurts.
I think he's an 80. I think he might actually be an 80. I think he might actually be 81. I do like Adam Ottavino as well. He's under the closer column. But I like him. I have lots of success with him.
K-Rod's an 80. You are correct.
Yeah, I thought I was going to say.
The flashback's pretty sure he was too, an 80. So you were right there.
Excellent. First time for everything.
Yeah, Adam Ottavino is good. Does Fernando Rodney? I want to say one of his circle change is pretty nasty.
Yes. He's another. But it's fastball changeup, and if somebody guesses right, you're in big trouble.
Yep. That would be quite a problem.
Yes. Anyway.
I'm just going to look real. I'm just looking at the the thing real quick. Nick Vincent is also pretty good.
Yep. Very good. Nick Vincent has a very good slider.
Sean Burnett. Did you hear the story about Sean Burnett?
No.
So he had Tommy John. And his arm, the ligament got stretched out.
Yeah.
So he doesn't throw that hard anymore.
Right.
Or at least this was, I think it was 2 years ago. So he doesn't throw that hard anymore. And he went back to Dr. James Andrews. and he was like, "Hey, let's do this Tommy John thing again. Cut me open. I'm ready. Let's do this right now." Dr. James Andrews was like, "Yeah, your thing's still attached. I'm not just going to go in there and cut that thing and make it tight again." Right. He was like, "Oh, okay." So that night, he went to his hotel, put the mattress up against the wall, or maybe both mattresses. I think it might have been two queens. Grabbed a bag of baseballs and just started throwing them full bore at the mattresses to try to get his muscle to snap. He couldn't do it. Got into spring training, and I think in like his first spring training game, I think it was like 2 years ago, it ripped off, it popped, and he was really happy. He went, he got Tommy John for the second time, and now he's a 79 overall lefty in Diamond Dynasty if you want him.
Well, I don't, but
crazy. That takes a certain kind of crazy to do that.
Yeah, absolutely. That is a bit crazy.
Yeah, so that's a lot of bullpen options. You got any more, or are you good there?
No, I'm good. I'm good for the bullpen. I do like I like Boxberger. Kevin Segrist is good as well.
Yeah, I think for
obviously if you're looking for a long man, Jim Palmer. If you have the 75 Jim Palmer, he is a fantastic card.
Yeah, I feel like all these closers in 3-inning games, assuming the stamina is right, you're going to put them in. They're all going to be tired.
Yeah, or maybe that, yeah, long man, I feel, is going to be very important.
Ooh, Jeremy like Jeffries. Said,
Jim Palmer's been very, very good for me, and he can be very, very good for you as well.
Jeremy Jeffries has nasty velocity. 4-seam, knuckle curve,
yep.
2-seam, and a sink. Yeah, I think we're talking a little bit about it on Twitter, I think. Anybody with like a wonky delivery might be good for these short games.
I would say.
So I want to look into that.
Gimmick pitchers, absolutely.
Yeah. So you want to start? We'll work. Start behind the plate and work our way around.
Yep.
I've got two picks here, because I always carry a backup.
Obviously.
I got flashback Brian McCann.
Yep.
He's got some good numbers, and also Francisco Cervelli, huge on the contact and a very good defensive catcher.
I have the exact same two. Nice. I would have Cervelli as my starter. Only because in a short game like that, I want the defense.
Yeah, I understand.
And I prefer, again, McCann's not a big slouch against lefties.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I think he's got the numbers. Because he's got those weird splits, remember?
Yeah, but I feel like it's been adjusted this year. I feel like he's back to a more conventional.
No, he's 62 contact versus righty, 80 contact versus lefties.
Okay, so and he's better.
32 power versus righties, 71 power versus lefties.
Okay,
so. And again, the reason I put this as built this as a lineup, not just specifically individual positions.
Yes.
So this I put McCann in because he was the lefty.
Yeah, that makes sense. Like I said, me personally, I prefer Cervelli, but you know, but it is what it is. I mean,
it's a great combo.
You can't go wrong with either of them.
Yep, definitely. First base, I have Greg Bird, the rookie flashback to 78. He has, if I'm not mistaken, is it like 94 power or something ridiculous like that? Yeah, 66 contact versus righties, 94 power versus righties. 69 fielding will play okay. Pretty good card overall. I really like the power because I feel like I had with in the bronze tournament that we did, I feel like you have to take a couple shots with guys. That are going to be not that great on the split. But if you get a righty starter, if you got Greg Bird with 94 power versus righties, that's huge for you. That's a big advantage.
Yeah. There. Yeah. I don't disagree. I feel like you need to take risks. Mm-hmm. Me personally, I had two possible picks here. The first one is Ken Griffey Sr. Mm-hmm. 94 contact versus righties. 76 contact versus lefties. He does have 71 fielding. So, you know, again, pretty good fielding for his baseman, good contact. Again, if you're looking for a more contact guy instead of Greg Bird. The other option is Justin Morneau,
mm-hmm.
Who has 90 contact versus righties, 79 contact versus lefties.
And 79 vision, don't slouch.
Yep, 50s in the power. And again, 68 fielding. So I would For this event, we're starting tomorrow. I'd probably go Griffey, mostly because I've been using him and have kind of a certain level of comfort with him because he's on my team that we're using in the Bullpen Banter tournament that I'm still in.
An Ike Davis flashback does the same as the Greg Bird. You could go that way. Greg Bird's a little bit better against lefties than Ike Davis is. Some other names, Chris Colabello. He's pretty even, 70s in the contact, 60s in the power. That's kind of nice. If you want to go crazy, you can use like a Chris Carter. It doesn't have a ton of contact or a ton of vision, but 92 power versus righties, 94 power versus lefties.
Yeah.
Justin Bour also looks like a man-child that's going to
hit some monster. I feel like I wish they would have set like the overall team threshold at like 75 to force you to take a low bronze or like a couple commons. Mm-hmm. But I mean, because it's 79, you literally don't have to even look below 75 for the most part.
Yeah. Detroit sports guy likes James McCann behind the plate. He's also pretty good.
Yeah, James McCann's pretty good. I don't disagree. James McCann's a good all around option.
Napoli at first, not bad. I do like Billy Butler. He's got 97 contact versus lefties and 83 power versus lefties with 76 vision. He was actually on this team until I remembered about this Greg Bird. But if you want to risk it somewhere else and have a guy that's very righty centric at another position, or that hits righties very good at another position, and use Billy Butler as your lefty specific guy, you can definitely do that.
Yeah, you can make that work absolutely.
Then at second base, I've got a trio of guys. I've got Jonathan Scope in the lineup, just because he's got 80 defense, 90 arm, 64 contact versus righties, 70 power versus righties.
Yep.
But then on the bench, I have Joe Panik, who I like. He's got lots of contact, 73 versus righties, 76 versus lefties, 92 vision, 88 fielding. So he's definitely going to play. I feel like he'd be like he might be a defensive replacement later, but he doesn't have the arm. But if you need a base hit late in the game, because you're going to be pinch hitting probably a lot in this game, I feel like Joe Panik's going to slap you some singles. And then, low key, probably our favorite new player that we've learned about. Hernan Perez. He is a second baseman by trade. Also has third base, shortstop, left field, and right field. 62 contact versus righties, 65 against lefties. He got an IE boost today. He's only got 4 stars. He's getting +6 to contact versus righties and power versus righties.
Yeah.
So that's nice. Also, 89 speed, 87 stealing, 85 base running aggressiveness. Which I guess base running aggressiveness doesn't matter, right? I assume that's a sim stat.
But I believe so, yes.
70 fielding, so he's not going to be amazing anywhere. But he's got tools to be extremely key for you in a clutch situation.
Yeah, I like Hernan Perez. I got Hernan Perez on the bench, absolutely 100%. I disregard Jonathan Scope because he's so bad against lefties.
Mm-hmm. I mean, in the 40s and 50s, but I think
his 48 contact and 49 power. I do like him, but the thing is, I would rather have the Joe Panik because 73 contact versus righties and 76 contact versus lefties, and he's got 8 extra points of fielding. 88 fielding is that's top shelf.
Actually, Joe Panik fielding. Joe Panik is my second baseman. Just in the game.
Yeah, Joe Panik would be my guy. Again, Hernan Perez on the bench because he plays 5 positions. And 89 speed. Another guy, if you want to gamble, Jose Altuve, rookie, 61 contact versus righties, but 96 contact versus lefties and 94 speed. He could be the kind of guy. And if you're looking for one other guy, I wrote down just for cheap pop was Jed Gyorko or Gyorko, however it's pronounced. 81 power against righties.
That's pretty nasty.
So, if you're looking for some pop, Gyorko's pretty much the only guy.
Yeah, there's a lot of guys. There's a lot of guys in there that are decent contact, decent power that you could swap.
Yeah,
I agree. Some have better vision. Some have a little bit better this and that. Like a Brock Holt's also good. I assume he can play all the positions.
Yes.
Yeah, first, third, short, left, center, right, and second. So he can play everything but catch and pitch.
Hey, I just got Justin Morneau as a post-game reward.
Hey, look at that. Ryan Schimpf, 54.
Ryan Schimpf's got some pop. Yep,
80 versus lefties, and I think there's some speed guys in there that you can play with as well.
Yeah, second base is definitely a position where you can kind of, do what you feel.
Yep,
If you want a defensive guy, you can get a defensive guy. You know, Ponick gives you contact defense. You can go power. You can go, you know, lots of different ways at second base.
Yeah. For third base, I went with the Alex Bregman we've talked about earlier. He gives you a little bit of everything. 88 arm, 83 fielding are the things that I really like about him. But, you know, around 60 on both sides of the contact, and same for the power and the vision. He's got just a good spread. I mean, there's a lot of guys. But
okay, so I've got Bregman, no doubt. But there's two other guys, three other guys I made note of just to throw them out there.
Can I add one thing about Bregman?
Yes.
Because he's pretty average, like average at everything.
Yep.
If he's got IE boosts going up, he's going to be pretty good in a couple categories.
He's going to be pretty good in a couple. I don't disagree. I like the Bregman. Again, we talked earlier in the show about how Bregman is definitely a guy you want to be stashing for later in the season. Like, you definitely want to have
get yourself five.
You definitely want to have him. Yeah. So just you know, to play the other side of the coin for guys who might not have Alex Bregman, I mean, he is going to cost you 190 stubs, which for a bronze card, people aren't going to want to pay. Jake Lamb hits righties very well, 69 contact, 79 power. Yanjervis Solarte, again, 70 contact versus righties, 70 contact versus lefties.
And he's going to foul off long balls.
Yeah, big negative with Lamb and Solarte is they have arm strength in the low 70s. Mm. So, you know, if you get some speedsters, a guy who can bunt, you're going to be in a little bit of trouble. One other guy, Danny Valencia. The only reason why I mentioned Danny Valencia is he, with IE boost today, 89 contact versus lefties and 61 power versus lefties. He is a lefty killer. But, again, Valencia, major defensive liability.
That's without the IE boost, right? These numbers don't reflect the IE boost, right?
Oh, on Daddy Leagues?
No,
Daddy Leagues.
You have to add it.
Oh.
So his 89 power versus right, his 89 contact versus lefties is actually 99.
Wow.
And his 61 is actually 73.
Valencia is worth having. Again, I wouldn't use him as a starter, but Valencia is worth having on your bench. And I just discovered a Brandon Guyer breakout mission.
Nice.
Solid.
What else we got here? David Wright can hit lefties good. Who else? I just saw Martin Prado, 99 contact versus lefties, 86 vision, 86 arm, but the 55 fielding got to be a little bit questionable.
Yeah.
Who else? Eugenio Suarez is all right. Juan Uribe has got fielding and arm. If you want to go a little bit more defense, he still has some of the stick. Gallo, 78 power versus righties, 71 versus lefties. He took me yard in a game that I was playing earlier. There's options. Even Pablo Sandoval, 79 contact versus righties, 81 vision is nice.
Yeah.
Lots of options around there. And again, a lot more guys with a full circle, except for maybe stealing. So that's good. Chris Johnson, 99 contact versus lefties.
Yep. Yeah, Chris Johnson's always a favorite lefty killer.
Mm-hmm. Listella's 84 vision, so he's going to be fouling off a lot of balls. A lot of options there.
Excuse me.
What do we got? Shortstop?
Yep.
Hit me. I got what's the story? Trevor Story.
Trevor Story. Got to be Trevor Story. No better player to have than Trevor Story. 80-plus power versus both sides. Half-decent contact as well. A little bit of speed as well, 58.
I didn't realize the arm was so weak.
Yeah, the one trade in with Trevor Story is 66 arm strength is a problem.
Yeah.
But the thing is, when you compare it to people in this cat, I mean, Gregorius has 70s.
Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of people are going to go DD here. Mid 60s contact versus both sides, 78 arm strength. A lot of people are going to go DD. Low key, Unel Escobar. Don't sleep on Unel Escobar here.
I was just looking at him. He looks not terrible. Great contact, you know, good vision, good fielding. He looks pretty good.
80 contact versus righties, 84 versus lefties, and 75 arm strength. Definitely can't sleep on Escobar. The thing is, like, again, Trevor Story is the play.
He's got
just have to be aware that the arm strength is a problem.
He's one of those guys that you can use as the sellout for power and not hopefully not hurt your team too bad. Can he play? I mean, you could put him to third or second.
Yeah.
And you might be okay.
Eduardo Escobar has 21 points of IE boost today.
Just FYI. Really?
Yeah, that's pretty insane.
Dansby's got some contact. Zach Cozart's got some power versus lefties. There's a lot of options here.
There's definitely a lot of options, but I don't think any of them are as good as Trevor Story.
Yeah, for a position that doesn't have a lot of power, he's got a lot of power.
Yeah.
And in a three inning game, you kind of are hoping that the defense isn't going to kill you. Because again, you're getting 9 outs. What are the odds that multiple balls are getting? What are the odds that the fast guy is going to hit a ball to Trevor Story? I mean, if I'm hitting, I'm going to try to make it that case, but I don't know. We'll see. I'm just going to spit out my outfield real quick.
Yep.
Though I have like 5 guys. Christian Yelich, rookie. I just got that in a pack yesterday.
Yeah.
It has, what is it? 95 contact versus righty, 76 speed, 70s for reaction arm and fielding.
Yep.
Not a lot of power, but I'll take a guy with 95 contact, let him lead off. Hope that works out, and I don't face a lefty. I got Frankie Gutierrez in center field.
Nice. I just pulled him in a post-game reward, actually.
88 arm, which is nice. 82 fielding. 50 speed in center field, probably going to be a problem.
That's going to hurt you.
But 76 reaction and 82 fielding, I'm hoping will make up for a little bit of that. But he gives me 57 contact versus righty sucks, but 77 contact versus lefties is good, and a 91 power versus lefty and righty. He can play all 3 positions, so maybe the move would be to stash him in a corner and not worry about him as much.
Yeah, probably.
I've also got Steven Piscotty in right. He's kind of a beast. 72 contact versus righties, 81 contact versus lefties, 96 clutch, and some decent power. Again, he can play all 3 outfield positions and first base as well. Then I went down the list a little bit. No more 79 overalls. I'm going to play the field like Ben Revere.
Nice. Ben Revere, Ben Revere's on my list as well.
I'm trying to think. He's a left fielder.
He's a left field, yeah. I'm looking at him right now, actually, on the Daddy Leagues.
I'm trying to pull him up in the game. So he has 76 contact versus righties, 81 contact versus 81. Lefties, 95 vision. Here's the secret low-key OP tip for these games. You kind of want dudes with high vision.
Oh, absolutely.
If you can fight off and make at-bats last 8, 10, 12 pitches, you're going to kill guys.
So advantageous.
So 95 vision, 93 speed, 88 stealing, 86 reaction, 80 fielding. Maybe you could probably start him in center. Start him in center, lead him off. If you start him in center, lead him off, have a good leadoff at bat, get them, 10, 12 pitches into the game. By the time your cleanup guys are coming up, they're either going to the pen or their starter's going to be gassed.
Yeah. So, yeah, you're definitely going to be in a desirable situation for your team.
And then my last pick is the GOAT, Ichiro. 62 contact versus righties, 79 contact versus lefties, which is still weird because he's a lefty. 81 vision, 86 speed, 84 reaction, 86 arm, 91 fielding. Dude can nice. Still ball out of control.
Yeah, those are all outfield is again. It depends what kind of outfield you want to put together. So me personally, some other guys that I have Gerardo Parra. 93 fielding and 94 arm strength. He's not great at the plate. I mean, he does have 64 vision, 60 contact versus righties, but he has fantastic fielding, 74 speed. So again, as a defensive guy,
what position? Sorry.
Left field.
He's a left fielder.
Okay. Yep.
I'm trying to find him.
Yep.
Oh, wow. That's a cannon and the fielding. That's
yeah.
Can you,
so defensively,
does he play? He could play in center.
He could definitely play in center with 74 speed.
Definitely.
Yep. A lot of people, I hate a lot of people are going to do this, but a lot of people are going to pick Kyle Schwarber.
Yeah. Lots of pop.
Yeah. You know, defensive. You can pick Kyle Schwarber. You can stick him behind the plate. He's a liability behind the plate. He's a liability in the outfield.
47 fielding?
Yeah. Jeez. A lot of people are going to pick him because of that bat against righties. I would caution you to absolutely not do that.
Yeah.
Please save yourself the heartache. Don't pick Kyle Schwarber. As much as you want to, please, please don't pick Kyle Schwarber.
And then on the flip side, if you see other people with Kyle Schwarber,
hit the ball in his direction.
If you can hit it in his direction, because he doesn't have the fielding, doesn't have the arm stuff, and it, especially if they stash him behind the plate, if you got guys with, like, I don't know what the bottom of the limit would be, I'd be like 75 speed, I would think about going.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, I'd be going with guys at 50 speed.
I mean, maybe 50 speed's a little bit ridiculous, but but I hear you.
Red Sox is asking, do you, what's his blocking?
I don't know if you can see that here, can you? I don't think
No, I don't think you can. No.
You might be able to see it on Daddy Leagues.
In center field, I have one guy I really like is Leonis Martin. Mm-hmm. Again, you know, around 60s in the contact department. He has taken a bit of a he's taken a minus 11 boost to his lefty stats today. Again, great fielding though. 78 fielding, 94 arm strength in center field is fantastic. Okay. 81 speed. Is great. So I like Leonis Martin. I do like your Gutierrez as well. Ridiculous power. Franklin Gutierrez doesn't have that kind of power in real life, but I'll take it in this game.
Yeah, you can put I would probably recommend putting Gutierrez in a corner or coming off the bench with that.
I mean, he
can play.
Depends on what stadium you pick. I mean, he does have good fielding and arm strength, and his reactions are 76. So depending on what stadium you play in, if you're the home team, you could get lucky. Juan Lagares is popular as well.
I actually used him in our tournament.
Tournament? Yeah.
Again, bench, maybe. I don't think he played.
Very good defense. Again, minus 12 against righties is his IE boost for today, so his contact is usually up in the 70s on both sides.
Do the math.
What?
You have to subtract.
So it's actually 52.
62 is his base. Minus 12, he'd be having a 50.
Okay, because I'm looking at it on the market now. So even on the market, it's not actually reflected in his stats.
Right, unless I'm extremely mistaken.
Oh, well, that's...
I don't believe that's correct.
Okay, well, that's pretty dumb.
Yeah, so he's really bad against righties today. He'd be in 50 and like 22 power.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
I'm good. Yeah, that's not good. But, hey, Juan Lagares.
David Dahl, 85 speed, 73 contact versus righties, 73 contact versus lefties. That could play. Not my favorite arm in center, though.
And then over in right field, I think Piscotty's got to be the play. I think he does. I can't really think of anybody better than Piscotty in right field.
The only one I was thinking was maybe like a Nomar Mazara.
Yeah. I mean, you could go Matt Kemp. You know,
the full circle, kind of. The speed, the reaction, the fielding. Even in right field, you kind of want a little more than that.
He's an average player. Obviously, Adam Duvall is going to be a popular pick for a lot of people.
A lot of power.
Massive power. He did really well for me in both Bullpen Banter tournament games. He had a pinch-hit home run in one game and a pinch-hit two-run double in the other game. Mm-hmm. He was the reason why I won both games. Duvall also qualifies at first, third, and all three outfield positions. Ooh. So, and with 72 fielding and 70 arm strength, you could use him at third. Mm. I wouldn't personally, but you could. So the power plays as well. And that's pretty much it.
D-Star 1 says Yasmani Tomas off the bench, 86 contact versus lefties, 77 power versus lefties, and a 92 laser beam.
Yeah, I don't disagree with Tomas.
If you want to go a little more defensive, Jason Hayward, he's got 75 contact versus righties and 75 vision, but his fielding is off the chain.
Yeah, and I agree. I think you have Ichiro on yours as well.
Yeah.
And I agree with Ichiro. The fielding, again, if you did have someone like an Adam Duvall or a Matt Kemp, Ichiro is a guy you could put in the third inning with a lead and hold it down for you.
Mazzara's got 78 contact versus righties, 80 power versus righties.
That's not bad.
That'll play. I think that's my whole team. We should have built our teams and used them.
Oh, hey, there's new packs in the store. Oh, my. Okay, so hot breaking Bullpen Banter news. There are new packs in the store right now. They're not really that new. I think they've been there for 9 hours. It is a 25-card pack of all bronze and common cards. I'm not making that up.
Okay.
3,000 stubs.
Not so super excited.
So basically, you're getting four regular packs for you're getting one pack free.
Do we know if they're? No, it's all players, so you're getting more than that.
Yeah, still. Oh, I suppose yeah. So you're getting one, two, three, four,
six. Yeah, six plus six and a quarter.
No, because you get six players in a pack. So you're getting four plus one player. You get
six players. I'm sorry. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, because pretty much in the pack. You know what? I'm ripping one of these. Can you get better than bronze or common though? I don't care. I'm ripping one right now.
We need to do this for testing purposes, is what you're saying?
Yep, I'm doing it. I'm opening it right now. 25 bronze and common.
I'll open one too. Hopefully we get some flashbacks or something in there.
Let's go. Chris Heston, Zach Davies.
Let's go.
Josh Rutledge, Howie Kendrick, Peter Borges. So far all bronzes. Clay Buchholz, Jason Castro, Nomar Mazara, Michael Martinez, Jonathan Holder, Jason Shreve, Cliff Pennington. Oh my God, here comes the commons. Lady Tommy Fam,
Pennington.
That's Nick Wittgren, that Andrew fam? Bailey.
Love that fam.
Reed Brignac, Brock Stewart, Will Middlebrooks, Yonder Alonso, who's got a 10 overall boost today.
Shout out to Yonder Matt Alonso.
Matt Decker.
Yonder Alonso.
Hey, low this pack is total fire. Eddie Gamboa.
The GOAT. Boom.
Just Chris Russon. Brett Oberholzer, Brett Wallace, Mike Avilas.
B. Wallace got the power. Mike Avilas got contact. There's some.
So I got 8 out of the 25 cards were bronze, and 17 were common.
To be fair, 5 of those you could probably play with. You got Nomar.
Oh, yeah.
All right, let's do this. I'm ripping one. For science.
For science.
All right, we got Tyler Jungman. Not bad. 60s around the board. I can live with that. Yeah. Omar Despange, 60s around the board. I don't know if I can live with that. Aaron Blair, shout out to the Braves. Wade Miley, can't see the cards. I can't see what kind of pitcher mix he has. Kyle Gibson, also not terrible. 86 stamina, some stuff in the 60s and the 50s. Brock Holt, he's got the 70s for the contact. We can live with that. Michael Marriott, okay. Darwin Barney, shout out to my dude. Daniel nice. Winkler, give me all the Braves. Oh, the cards just disappear at some point. Cool. Dylan Foro. Mm-hmm. German Marquez. Matt Whistler. Shout out. We got 3 Braves SPs. Let's go. Chris Young. He's a monster. Adam Frazier. 71 contact versus righties, 60 contact versus lefties. That might play.
Nice.
Sean Armstrong. Ben Gamel, if you need some speed and a little bit of reaction.
Nice.
Logan Andrusik.
Oh, hey, yo.
T. Featherstone, shout out to your boy. Nick Martinez. Fat Albers, crushing it.
I like it.
Tyler Austin, yo.
What's up, Tyler Austin?
Here's the problem. He's a 63. So I don't think he's going to get the bumps we need to get something right. Better than... what's bronze end at? 70? The bottom of bronze is 70?
Yes.
I don't think he's going to get up there. I'm stockpiling a couple Tyler Austins just to be safe.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to get there, though.
Maybe he gets a position change. Maybe something happens. Who knows? Jason Petrica, 87 home runs per 9, which doesn't matter.
Nope.
John Gant, former Brave starting pitcher. And Luis Perdomo.
Fire pulls. But the question is, how many 25 mans did you just complete?
Probably, I don't know, maybe one.
I don't know, man. Maybe one.
I don't know.
Hey, that's a banner.
I don't know. I feel like for 3,000 subs, that's not terrible. 25 cards, yeah. 3,000 subs. Break out Windows calculator again. Let's say I sell them all for 25 cards, or I sell them for 30 a pop. That's 750, so we're almost there.
Nice.
That's not bad.
Yeah, that's not awful. I've seen worse things. again, with the event, you can't be surprised that they come out with something like that.
Yeah, but that actually does excite me, because now you got to assume for other events there will be packs like this.
Yeah, you could assume that, yeah.
So that's cool. Like, I'm happy about that idea.
Yeah. I agree. I think I'm okay with them tying. I would rather see packs on a weekly basis tied to events than tied to stupid, crappy missions like last year where you're trying to get equipment.
True. I can do the White Sox 25, man.
Oh, I just got the Royals.
Not the Royals. One away from the Twins.
Nice.
Then do I just do the Twins? What's the Twins 40, man? It's a Phil Hughes, like 89 Phil Hughes?
Yes.
Something like that, right?
All right, so should we jump into the Bullpen Banter mailbag?
Sure.
All right.
I'll start another game then.
You do that, and we're going to jump into the Bullpen Banter mailbag, get this thing moving along here. We're almost an hour and 40 minutes into it.
I know. Let people know.
So these questions are...
In theory, you know what we should have done? It was built our actual Browns teams and played them, but...
It's all good. Yeah, but you know what? It's always. I understand you're still reeling after your opening day L to me.
Hey, man, I win games that matter.
That game mattered. That game was for the kids, man. That game mattered a great deal.
Trying to help out those Canadian kids. They got enough hard problems being.
I did the Rangers too.
Born in Canada.
Which is good because that means I'm one step closer to Buddy Bell.
Yo, I want that Buddy Bell.
Yo, I want that Buddy Bell too, but all our golds are too expensive right now.
Yeah. I agree.
Okay, so this is a question that Beiniger posted in the Discord earlier today. What missions are you going for first? What dailies do you not like?
Can I just give you a shout-out? I believe it's like pronounced vinegar, but with a B.
Vinegar? No, I'm calling it Beiniger.
Go right ahead.
I don't even care.
Go for it.
Answer the question, sir.
I didn't listen to you at all.
What Silver kind of squad. Missions? What missions have you been doing first?
I did the
Braves. What dailies do you not enjoy?
There's some dailies that I just reroll every time I see them. I need an angel for a save. Is a daily I've been skipping.
Yeah,
then some stuff. Whenever it's like an extra innings one, I've been skipping because I feel like extra innings. A lot of the missions don't use extra innings. The new home of the Atlanta Braves. Kind of skipping that kind of stuff.
I've been re-rolling all the Conquest ones because I'm not playing Conquest. Especially considering how the games for it have not been counting. I've been re-rolling the Conquest ones for now. I may do them at a later date, but I'm not doing them now.
Makes sense.
Next question. Can't remember who it's from.
Also did the Braves and probably I'm working on the Braves. Team Epic now, I guess. Hey, it's up. No, it's actually down. Well, there we go.
Awful. Somebody sell me German Marquez, please. I just got 425 man stun.
Nice.
Yeah. I did the Jays just so I could get their banner thing.
I don't really feel like I'm going to do the 25 mans until... I'm going to do the complete game because I don't... feel like it's really worth it.
I did like 12 of them for like 900 stubs.
Oh my god, Jose Iglesias. Give me a clip. That's a nasty, nasty play. Deep in the hole. Unbelievable. He boosts 15 feet.
People are saying, Red Sox is saying the stream is back.
Yeah.
Okay, so we were asking how many player epics have you received missions for so far? You said just one?
Just Starlin Castro so far. I have done two player spotlights.
Right.
I had Jorge Posada and Paul Konerko. So I don't know what the difference is. I guess Starlin Castro leads to something at some point, right? I need hits with Cubs.
I've gotten two player epics. One is for 93 Ian Kinsler, where I had to get a double with a Tigers second baseman in Conquest, which I never did.
How? Because you don't play Conquest, right?
Yes.
But you have Ian Kinsler.
No, but this is the 93 Ian Kinsler.
Oh, you have to do it with him?
No. So what it is it showed up in the daily missions.
Uh-huh.
And then if I would have gotten a double in Conquest with the Tigers second baseman, it would have unlocked the player epic mission to get Ian Kinsler.
Uh-huh.
The other one that I have.
I'm confused. And I'm actually, why didn't you do it?
Why didn't I do it? I tried and failed.
Keep trying.
I know.
The try and the fail. A few things that's great.
I tried to fail. The other one that I have is I have the player epic to get rookie Jose Altuve, which I have not done yet either. But I have to get four runs with bronze players in, so I'll just wait and do that as part of my job. Back into the mailbag. Kring Kong 556 asks, Carlos Martinez just became the fourth pitcher to have 10 plus Ks and no walks and no runs in opening day start. Should people be stashing him?
Check the thing. I wonder if stuff went up.
Is Carlos Martinez going to be? He's an 83, I believe.
Get him. Knocking on the door of gold already. He was gold last year, I think, right?
I think he made it to gold last year.
Yeah. So I think he's only down in silver because of the stuff.
Yeah, because of the ratings downgrades for the recalculations. So Carlos Martinez,
right field and to left field at the same place.
Carlos Martinez is an 82. It's a pretty dominant card for an 82.
I think he'll get the bump for gold. I definitely.
And he's going for right. If you put an order in, it's going to cost you $1,300 right now to get him.
Not bad.
So that's not bad.
You gotta believe he's going gold. But it might be a couple weeks, so.
Yeah, that's definitely worthwhile. Worthwhile pickup. If you want to pick up Carlos Martinez, Kring Kong dropping in with the some opening day IRLs.
Is there another one that he had in there?
He's talking about Mad Bum. First ever pitcher to hit two home runs on opening day.
Any one thing I
here's a more telling stat for Mad Bum. Yes, he hit two home runs yesterday. He became only the second player in Major League history to hit two home runs of 112 plus mile an hour exit velocity in the same game. You know who the other one is?
Jason Hayward in this game, but it was foul balls.
Giancarlo Stanton.
Ooh.
Mad Bum is in Giancarlo Stanton territory.
Yeah, Mad Bum rakes. Zigfoot, thank you for the follow. Appreciate that very much. Into the
wind. Hey, Zigfoot. Let's go. Pilot Vlogs wants to know, will the show ever get launch day service ready?
Hope so. They got the game right, which I would say is more important. But a close second would be the servers working.
Servers working would be good. I honestly, I mean, I want to say yes, that someday the servers will be working. But I feel like that's probably not the right answer. I feel like there's always, again, the thing is that when they add so much content to a game like they did this year that all requires online connectivity, it's almost like you knew there was going to be issues. I mean, we've talked about it from like episode 35 until episode 41. Are the servers going to work day one? Are the servers going to work day two? Are the servers going to work the first week? When you add as much stuff to Diamond Dynasty, which is all online dependent, what did you think was going to happen?
And I feel like it's actually better than last year.
Yes.
I mentioned this on last week's Press Row podcast. We gave our early impressions. This is a Sony first-party game. Like, get your stuff together. You're Sony. You should be able to figure this out. Also, Sony San Diego, that studio only makes... I mean, if you consider this game, I would say this game requires online. Studio only makes games that require online. They've got Guns Up, I believe, is free to play.
Something we're drawing.
They have Drawn to Death, which is going to be coming out, I think it's PS Plus, next week. That's a completely online multiplayer shooter type thing. Killstrain. I believe Drawn to Death is PS Plus. But it is it's a $20 or $40 game.
Right.
They were going to go free to play, but I think they saw that free to play on console just didn't really work. Even though they already have, I believe, Killstrain, and I forget what the other one I said before. Sony San Diego only makes games that are online dependent. So the fact that this has so many problems makes me really worry about those other games. Granted, those other games aren't really in my up my alley, but he doesn't get the call. It's two and two. I would be like, if I was someone that was a Sony San Diego in general fan, I'd be kind of worried about those other games.
Set to deal on two and yeah. I don't disagree. My Note battery just died. Yeah. It's... I don't know. Like I said, I'm not confident that they're ever going to have a hiccupless launch when it comes to this stuff. I just don't think it's ever going to happen. I want to believe. I really want to believe. Like, you have no idea how much I want to believe. But I just can't. I can't do it. I can't. Like, go into it and think. There's just no history of it. There's no history of
them and, I mean, being able to do it. Servers are a real wonky thing because, like, your launch weekend is when you're going to have the most people on your servers. You're never going to have that many again. So, like, to plan for that is weird because you have to overshoot your guess. But then again, it's so easy to... I literally don't know. It seems nowadays, you know, spinning up servers is easier than ever before and quicker to be done. So I don't know if it's like something inherent to netcode and stuff. That's the problem. It's the problem. So I really don't know. I mean, it's gotten better than it was 4 years ago and 3 years ago. Every year seems to get better. I don't really feel like this is worse than last year, because at least last year you couldn't play games. This year you can play them. Sometimes they don't count, which is the problem.
That is a bit of a problem, yes.
So, I mean... And the two-out threat will not come to pass
as the inning is over. One hit, one error. It's tough.
Yeah, as FC2014 says, the thing you want is to keep the new players who buy the game. You want them to stay customers because, like we said earlier, I think a lot of people, you know, got the game. They try to get on and get their bonus packs and stuff, and they're having those problems right now.
Yeah, that's an issue. I mean, it's tough. It's really tough to sit here another week into another MLB The Show launch and what, you know, you can't go on social media without seeing so much negativity about the servers.
And again, like we said, it's not just those people, but it's all the people that aren't on social media that have no idea why the stats aren't getting counted and all this stuff. Yes. They're just like, no, this game's just broken. So... I mean, I really hope they get it together very quickly this year, and then, you know, get a little bit better next year and a little bit better the year after, and get a game back on Vita, and it'll be good.
Oh, yes, that's what we need.
No, we just need someone to lose the handle. What else? We got anything else on there?
That's pretty much it for the mailbag.
I could be in the chat with any questions.
That's pretty much it for the mailbag.
When he hung him, I left a curveball hanging. Enjoy Bassett enough to stop with that one.
Excellent. That's not going to be good.
It's going to really hurt my undefeated streak.
Oh, no.
Oh, wow.
You don't want to hurt your undefeated streak. That's terrible.
Miguel Sano hit one into a guy's ankle in the upper deck.
How? As God is your witness, you may have broken in half.
Hanging curveballs. Not great.
I have 15 games pitched with Jim. 40 innings with Jim Palmer already. 62 Ks.
Wait, I didn't even know where you could look at the stats. They're on the cards, right?
No, well, I'm looking at the player stats right above game history on your matchup, on your squad screen. They actually have like things like ERA and WHIP, like... You can see them.
What are they accurate? That's probably not what he
wants to do with two strikes. They look very accurate. He is fortunate he just fouled it off. And he'll try very, very accurate. But he'll hold back
here. It's 1-2. Will the home run title go to Madden this year? If you base it on like home runs per bats, make him see if probably. Chase that slider in
the dirt. Fenway is the most overrated stadium in MLB. Get out of here with that. Fenway's awesome.
There, but they don't understand how to pitch there. That's why they get lit. I think
Red Sox might be talking IRL.
No, we said he's in MLB.
Yeah, in the MLB.
In the MLB. No, Fenway's pretty dope. I mean,
yeah, Fenway's legit.
Fenway's dope if you're a baseball fan. I think if you're a normal person, Fenway kind of blows.
Yeah.
We took a – I went there last spring.
Right.
Or early in the spring. For a – I was going up there for a Garth Brooks concert. And went – took a tour of Fenway. And the seats, like the regular seats, yo, your boy can't sit in those. Like, I do not fit in those seats.
Yeah.
Those are like make airplane seats look roomy.
Oh, that's no good.
And here's a ball hit little dinky. In there, a
base hit. That is no good. And he's safe. Well,
didn't try to do too much with it. Two strikes
on him. I feel like everyone is played out for it being the first season two, technically sort of kind of. I mean, it can't really be season two without Millennium here. Yeah, he's got his own priorities. And they obviously don't include us. Tier. But hey, it's been good. I mean, you know what? All in all, bottom line, I'm enjoying the show. The server issues aside.
Baseball wise, this is by far.
Yes, server issues aside, I'm really enjoying the game.
Yep. Agreed, 100%.
I don't think I can sit here and say that it's a negative game, or I just got Dave Steve playing. I just loaded up a head-to-head game. I got Dave Steve. This ought to be good.
Should the Yankees be concerned about Tanaka? Probably not. Wasn't he like the best pitcher in spring training?
It's one game.
Small sample size.
No, they shouldn't be concerned about Tanaka.
Who was it? Roof Ned Odor is on pace for 650 home runs.
Sweet.
If you are concerned that Roof Ned Odor is going to hit 650 home runs, you should be.
I'm pretty concerned he's going to hit 650 home runs.
And you should be worried about him.
I'm also worried about Tanaka. I'm worried. I think they had a reason to be worried about Tanaka last year and a couple of years ago when his was showing severe signs of fatigue, but I don't think they had to be worried about one game.
He did not have time.
No, he did not. There was worries he needed to have it. Oh no, that was a terrible play. What am I doing? Somebody actually just did something to Starling Marte. I can't believe it.
I just let Edwin run 441.
Nice. That's what I'm talking about.
Balls off the wall. So OP this year.
Yes.
Going second though.
Oh, this is my first game with Ryan Braun in the lineup.
Ooh.
Well, I just completed Brewers, right? So I've got Ryan Braun. Oh, you know what? I forgot to put the Axford in my lineup.
Axelmania?
Yeah. What? My runner just disappeared. He didn't run out of the box.
Guys, don't forget, you can follow us on Twitter, @ThatSportsGamer, @SnaggleJ. Oh, you know who you can follow? @JHeyKid. 22 might actually be his Twitter name. He just hit a ball deep into that good night. Don't forget you follow us on YouTube, youtube.com/thatsportsgamer/snaggleJ.
Please do.
The Twitches, click on our names, follow the channel if we'd appreciate that.
Do it.
Instagram.com/snaggleJ, hot channel.
Yes, sir.
We went to a baseball game. Where'd you go? You guys went to something, right?
That was Power Rangers?
You'd see Power Rangers, hot fire. Better than
hot
baseball.
Hot fire, Power Rangers.
Hot fire, better than baseball. I call Power Rangers.
Yeah. Hot fire, Power Rangers. Go see it in theaters today.
Which is your favorite Power Rangers? Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, the original OG series is pretty
of the OGs
good.
Of the Billy Trini.
Oh, Kimberly, for sure.
Obviously, right?
Obviously, right? What discussion are we currently having? Obviously. She is my favorite in the movie too, by the way, just for clarity's sake.
Because
the movie's the movie's based entirely on like the original American series.
Right, because they find Homeboy, right? Tommy's in it? Not Tommy, Jason? Wait.
Yeah, Tommy. Jason's the leader. No, Tommy's not in it.
So Tommy's the White Ranger. Which one's the green one? Which one's the green slash white? Is that Jason or Tommy?
Well, I don't want to spoil it, because it's a little different.
Green slash white's in it, right?
Jason green slash white was the same, yes.
He's in it, though. Right? Is he in the movie?
No, he's not in the movie.
Are you trying to stop me from a spoiler? Because I'm pretty sure he is in the movie. No. Maybe I'm wrong. I can be wrong. First baseman no. Eric
Hosmer is trying to hide spoilers. No spoilers. I'm not trying to hide spoilers.
A splitter, yeah, but I'm telling he started you. It too low as it bounces
up. We can talk about it. We can talk about it off stream.
Oh, I see how it is. He's in it. I told you. Oh God, another curveball. Yeah. So do those. Follow those channels. You can follow Operation Sports. They're not streaming this week. You can follow Millennium OS on Twitter if you really want. I don't know if I would recommend it.
Yes, definitely a mixed bag.
Go tweet at him. Where were you, you traitor? The 1-2 pitch. And then send him a Vince McMahon, you're fired gif.
Please do. Giphy.com/gif/Vince McMahon, you're fired.
Yeah. Is there for it. And that's the third out.
Do it.
I feel like that was a good bullpen banter.
I feel like that was good. I mean, 2 hours?
I still have to finish this game, so we're not leaving, but.
Well, I mean, I just started the game. It's in the second inning, and this guy's slow pitching me real bad.
When the game freezes, never ever leave. Leave your
kids alone. Yeah, never, never ever leave.
Turn your Xbox on. Just play that for a little bit.
Yeah, if you have one, yeah. Otherwise, just go have a sandwich.
Oh my God, hitting balls into the corner is so cool this year.
I know.
Yeah,
I love beating guys who shift their outfield. Like you slash a ball away from the outfielder, like I just did with Adrian Gonzalez.
Yeah, when it cuts like that. Masahiro
Tanaka is in for his second. Their guys running.
Sack bunt's OP. Really tell about how effective this guy's going to be when I go to sack bunt and he throws a pitch in the dirt.
Primetime missed the entire pitch of all our Twitter account stuff. He's asking, who are all the people doing this podcast with you? It's just me.
It's the
SNAG.
Yeah. Snaggle J and Millennium OS. Oh my God! I just drop it in. No. Oh man, so Tanaka couldn't lay down a bunt, and I put one good second baseman's head on a single. Yeet!
Oh, nice.
Yeah, at Snaggle J on Twitter, YouTube.
At Snaggle J.
At Starling Marte. Is Starling Marte? We get an at Starling
Marte. Go. You know what? If this channel ever gets partnered, Starling Marte has to be the first emote, right?
Oh my God, yes.
With just like goat horns.
Starling Goate. Can someone make a Starling Marte with goat horns?
Oh, I think my game just froze.
Did it freeze or did you win?
No, Buddy hit a single up the middle. So, and now it's just following Brock Holt all over the field.
Michael Brantley, the king of rolling into DPs. You should not be relatively new to hearing about Bullpen Banter. This is episode 42!
The Jackie Robinson episode. We should have skipped. Hey, I lost connection with Sniper Zone 341. Let's see if I get the season's points.
You can use BBTV to get free emotes if someone can get the art.
BTTV, yeah, I use it. It's a Chrome extension called Better Twitch. It allows you to do things like track your...
Oh, duh, you know what we should do? If someone can make it, we could just use it on the Discord.
True. I'll make sure to give you a follow, Snaggle J. Thanks, Primetime. Appreciate it, man. You can do that. I got the win. 79 points. 139 in seasons now. Hey, and the guy didn't get the loss for a disconnect. Oh, your rating doesn't go down?
That sounds shady.
Yeah, his rating changes zero.
If you can, I'm going to try throwing a curveball again. Ooh, that's a strikeout rather than hanging it just from the mile. Yeah, we can do Discord notes.
Yeah. So just full major, because we keep him. Oh, just got a live series, Logan Morrison. Major bullpen banter announcements. We do have a finalist in the first bullpen banter tournament. Johnny B. defeated Cardinals Red by a score of 8-2. So Johnny B. Will face the winner of myself and Official Mole. Ooh, probably going to happen tomorrow night.
It's going to be a good game. You got to play your Madden game tomorrow night, too.
Well, that's the big surprise. People have been asking for 6 months for Millennium and I to play one game of Madden head-to-head. Those people are going to get their wish tomorrow. Because Millennium and I are finally going to lock horns. Millennium and I are finally going to lock horns in a game of Madden tomorrow night. It's finally going to happen.
I can't believe it. you streaming that, or is he streaking it? I guess you're streaming it. He's taking the week off.
Well, I don't know. I don't know if we'll be streaming it on OS or if we'll be streaming it on my channel or if it'll be a dual stream or it might. We haven't worked out the semantics of it yet, but either way, it's definitely going to be live and in living color.
I mean, it sure sounds because like
when I whoop them by 50 points, I want there to be evidence.
It will be hosted right here.
It doesn't matter what channel it's on. It'll be hosted for sure. So that's it. The people will finally get the dream matchup they've been waiting for months.
Unless DJ Mateo starts in front of you, and then it'll probably switch go to him.
Oh, ouch.
Just saying.
I'll make sure to hit you in the Discord to get that old manual host fixed up.
I gotta play my game, too. So, well, I might be streaming, so you might be real streaming.
That's fine.
Oh, Jose Iglesias, guys. Get him. Vacuum. Time and the side is right. Yeah, he said he's taking the week off.
Yeah, he's taking the week. He's going, well, I guess, because he's going away this weekend, and then he's kind of taking a break playing some MLB and stuff. So you'll be able to watch it at twitch.tv/SnaggleJ, though. That's a guarantee.
Get signed up for the Discord. We'll probably do another tournament. Not this week. Maybe next week, the 21st-ish. Oh, Freddie Freeman. We just do one where I just get to use Freddie Freeman all the time.
I mean, that would be a nice one. Yeah. Freddie Freeman DP.
Finally get thrown out of second. They call him safe? Oh! So nasty. That's hilarious. Okay, there's a problem with that. Someone clip that. That's a problem. I was hosed at second base by a distance. And their first baseman did not leave the tag down.
That's not good.
Gotta get that clip. Send it to the team. Oh. Oh, Freddie Freeman with such a good base runner. Grounded to third, held his ground, and then when the throw went, he.
Well,
you can roll. I'm not gonna keep you up.
Yeah, I'm gonna roll. It's 12:35 local. It's been a long day. I was up till, not gonna lie, I did not get home. I watched the wrestling pay-per-views at a friend's house, who lives about like 6 minutes away. I did not get in bed until 5 to 2 this morning.
42 speed.
He had the PBR set up to go an hour over because on the network, like on the cable box, it was only scheduled to be on until midnight, like 11 Eastern. And it didn't get over till like 12:14 Eastern. So he missed the last 14 minutes. We missed the whole Undertaker retirement thing. But
I was
so
very
we had to
confused
find
by
that.
So I was like, why did he get dressed again to get undressed?
Yeah.
And then walk a mile and a half away.
And then break kayfabe for the first time ever. But people were like, you know what? As soon as he took the hat off and put it down, he was no longer the Undertaker, so there's no kayfabe anymore.
Sure.
So.
Now, didn't he take off the gloves at the other one after Lesnar beat him, or was that a different one?
That was, I can't remember, Jesus, a few years ago now.
He did it.
Either way.
Off the gloves somewhere.
Either way, I love all the pen pals out there in Bullpen Banter land.
Shout out to the pen pals.
Shout out to the Bullpen Banter pen pals for coming out to episode Jackie Robinson.
Last year after Shane beat him, he says.
Yes, I would take my gloves off after Shane beat me, too.
I'm sorry, Shane did not beat him, obviously. Here comes the
first pitch. Yes. Yes, that's true. He did win. All right, well, listen, enjoy your game.
Thanks, sir.
Beat the crap out of Puerto Rico. Cross-border tensions. Very high.
Can I just tell you, low-key OP, there's a little Puerto Rican place around the corner. It is so good. They make the dopest empanadas. Made me wait 45 minutes last time I was there, but still good. Still well done.
Okay. Nice.
Bad route, Magellan. Nice play. Starling Marte, the good. Still finding him. Thank you, Chris. Appreciate it.
Not a big trouble, as always. I'm going to now get out of the bullpen and get into the game. And the game is bed.
Yeah, I was going to say, you want a bed.
That's a game. All right, peace.
Take it easy. Geo Stanton. All right, let's try to wrap this game up. Call it a night. I would like to drop the 10th spot in this game. Oh, that's not... Oh, that had way too much of the plate. And thankfully... Just shade. And he brings not it enough. In for the second out of the inning. All right, 5-2. Tanaka kind of dealing 79 pitches. He's probably done after this inning. I could probably stretch him out, but I don't know if that's really worth it.
And this is going to be a foul ball.
Yeah, that was supposed to cut off the plate, but it did not. Or the cutter does stand, did not cut off the plate like it was supposed to.
And now ooh. A curveball that bounces up.
Come on, kid, you got to chase that. This is Adam Jones.
That's back-to-back breaking balls away, but now he's got himself into a little bit of a tough spot. You probably
good pitch,
can't
good
throw
pitch.
That again, so
I feel like those up and in fastballs, even at 92, are much more hard to hit this year.
I like that. Show him the curveball and then try to sneak that low 90s fastball by him.
Nope.
Off those breaking pitches.
Well, that's what you want from your curveball on
give
one
me slide piece.
You start it in the zone and let it break out of the zone where it can't be punished. Didn't get him to go after it. But
I mean, if that hits
nice.
The corner, he's
well, that's
out.
Back-to-back breaking balls. He's able
and
to
I'll
foul that one off.
Be safe.
Will they come back with a third?
Max effort.
This now is hit the second. Does he have
Joey
another
P using a bronze 2B on my squad. Just notice that. I'm using a bronze second baseman, and he's getting the job done.
Here this half. Your attention, Carter Capps.
Carter Capps coming in for them. Okay.
Digging in once
we need
again.
To warm up some guys. I want to get Blevins. And get in the home half let's get of the Ken Giles going.
Leading off for the Hitman, the shortstop.
Again, if you can just oh, is that fair? Got it. Ooh, got that for a double? Come on, sir. Yeah, Panic's fielding is good, and he's got really good contact, so he plays. Look at that. Right down the line. We'll kick up chalk, maybe. Oh, it's not what I wanted to do. I did exactly what he wanted me to do.
One down.
Not good. I need to just advance the run.
Greg
Bird or Cargo? Let's go. Who's the Iglesias? Let's go Cargo. I wonder if he'll walk Cargo. Good pitch, 100 miles per hour. Woof.
That's a big fastball, obviously, and we're going to see this reliever throw it a lot. Well, these hitters can expect.
Oh, come on, Blue.
That big fastball from this reliever, it's a
he's coming low and
in,
but we got to crush it.
Working for the punch out and the
oh, we stayed high, and we went there. Took it to the chop shop, sir.
Digging in and looking for more, Starling Marte. Two hits and three at-bats for him in this one. Bautista has a read on it. He hauls it in without any trouble.
Let's go, Cargo.
Left fielder number 23.
Here's Michael Brantley.
Dun, 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 dun.
Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one.
You going up again? Let's go.
This is pulled
ooh,
in the
ripping. Rippins.
Reach, he's got a base hit. The throw into second. And he
there we
will
go.
Pull into second with a
Dublé's all day over here. Got to get dirt pad. Michael Brantley, good job, sir. Edwin! Oh, if I can hit a bomb with Edwin right now, I would feel so good. So good on the inside. He's going to throw me a little deuce piece. We're going to crush it.
High in the air out to center field. Kiermaier's got a read on it.
Hit it a mile high, though.
Makes the catch, and that'll
ugh.
Retire the
that Cargo shot was legit.
But two come across boom. To score in the inning.
Jerry B.
Jerry
get in the game.
He's been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
I'm going to want to go warm up.
Now, called here as we'll get a trip to the
no,
mound.
Do that. Get Watson up.
Leading off for the All-Stars. Center fielder.
Very happy to hear that, Red Sox. Oh, God. Don't even move. Don't even move, Jay Hay. Don't even see the ball land. Okay. Again, cutter not where it needed to be. That needed to be another. Wow. That was supposed to be here.
First pitch of the at bat on its way.
Like that.
He's at the plate now, and he's quickly behind 0-1.
Got it, spots.
Good swing there. That was really ugly. Anytime you can make a hitter look like that, you've done something.
Gotta hit your spots this year.
Did it look to you like he was guessing on the pitch?
Oh, certainly it had to be, Matt, but if he was, he obviously wasn't looking.
I'm not hitting
that
my spots
pitch.
With buttons.
Swing and a liner. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Slow little roll.
Edwin Encarnacion playing third base for me, guys. Got that third base ability.
Once again, Eric Hosmer, one run in and one gone so far this
inning. Check.
Now he'll step.
Give me a verification. Yeah, stick with the lefty. So one more with him.
Curveball and that misses in the dirt for ball one. Bases are empty, one man out. A little late that time as he swings and misses for strike one.
Well, that is a good pitch. A sinker down with that kind of movement, it is really hard to hit. No wonder.
That's where I wanted that cut. That cutter to be.
And the changeup is way low.
OTP is $39.99. Use the code TSG18 to save yourself 10%. If you buy the standalone. Buy from Steam. It's full price. I don't have the promo code, but. Ooh.
As he swings through the curveball, two down.
You can use TSG 18 to save 10%, or you can use like Stream 18 to get 5. So you probably want 10%.
Like it didn't even happen before.
Jose Bautista is in with two away here as this one swung on and missed for the first strike.
We'll keep going, Blevins.
One count. Here's the pitch.
Now we're actually hitting spots with him.
Shallow right. Hayward has a read on it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Not before they're able to at least get one back.
Who out there was complaining about Kevin Kiermaier? That's what I wanted to know.
Here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman. He's roped a couple of doubles in three trips.
Dude, this pitch.
Good.
That was right over top of that.
Had him out in front for strike one. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. And here's a ball hit in the air.
Oh, drop for a double.
Into shallow left. He tracks it down. A nice running play, and there's one away.
Yeah, Evichem is also a very good
game. Gattis now standing in. We could really use a knock here over three.
I've barely touched
so
it, but from what I've seen, I've liked.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
Racking up them hits.
A nice clean base hit is first of the game.
Well, that's good hitting. 0-0. You want that fastball right where you're looking at it. Just take it right back at him. Nice one.
Evan Gattis has not really let me down here.
Here's Jason Hayward now.
Oh, I thought it was going to be the breaking ball. Man. Do I have a backup catcher out there I should worry about? Mr. Ramos. Okay. One out. What are we going to do here? Let Behan go ahead.
Billy Hamilton will come on now and pinch run here.
Who's their catcher? Salvador Perez? Probably not.
Billy Hamilton.
Come set and the 0-1. Look out,
not going to steal on him, but
wake you up a bit.
I need him there in case.
So that might have been a little bit of a message they were trying to send to hit him off the plate.
Oh,
the least,
might not need
a.
Go.
And on the play, the
and that is why you have him.
Position now at second.
That was a great job of driving that ball, extending his arms very well, was able to get it over the right fielder's head. One hopping it off the wall.
Ooh, that's not good. Oh, no, that's not good. Get down.
Bad time for a wild pitch as the run will score from third. A man at third with one away.
Something to the second baseman here. Not up in the air, though.
On the right side of the infield.
Hey.
Catch made there by Hosmer, and there are two gone now. But no, he'll put on the
okay, so we
got to
put in Wilson
Ramos.
I need Panic to get a hit so we can bring in a pitch hitter and double switch.
Joe Panic. He got under one and popped out his last time up. And this ball's going to find the seats down the left field line. Foul strike one. Comes set with the 0-1. Swing and a ball line softly down the right field
come
line.
Come on now, one time, let's go big, big hit.
Two outs here with a runner at third. Ripped down the first base line, but a foul ball,
just, like,
and the count holds it
0-2.
Kind of
swing.
He's just fouling him off till he gets something he wants to hit.
Pulled toward right center field. Kiermaier's got a read on it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. It's a run on two hits, one left.
Ninth inning coming up.
New Jersey leads this one 8-3.
Of the Braves. Okay, let's do some substitutions.
He homered earlier and is 2-for-3 to this point.
Let's put you in.
Troy Tulowitzki.
Oh, I screwed that one up.
Is into the ball game here as he takes over behind the plate.
Right, Iglesias can put third. Okay, I'm gonna take Edwin out. No offense, Edwin. I love you. We'll do that.
Wilson Ramos will also enter as he takes over at third base.
So I want Ramos behind the plate. I want Tulo. Oh, Tulo can play. Well, they have secondary positions for Tulo at second and third. Okay, I'll play with that. I can do that. Tulo at third.
First pitch of the at bat on its way.
Terrible idea to leave this guy.
Him up over toward foul territory, and this is going to wind up a foul ball.
So that's actually all week against lefties. Okay. As long as the energy's there.
On its way, the 0-1 pitch. This is swung on and lifted down the left.
I feel like if
line,
I throw that the loopy deuce, he's probably going to swing over. Or drive right up the middle.
A dive, but he can't get it. It's through into the outfield.
Okay, last batter for him. Throwing Brady Giles. Javier Baez hits lefties better than righties.
Right there, hit really hard. That makes him 3-for-4 on the day. What a day for him.
Ready for another shot now. Salvador Perez. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. The 1-0 delivery. Now a good pitch on the inside part of the plate ties him up.
Be better. Got to be better than that.
Really tied him up on that one.
Yeah, clearly didn't recognize where that was going to end up, Matt. If I were pitching, I might go right back in there.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2.
Ooh.
1-2 is the cut fastball, but he holds back 2-2.
Change piece.
2-2 count. Here it comes. And this is fouled back and out of play.
We need this sinker to be on point right here.
Fastball to get a change up and foul it off. Pretty good approach.
And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Wow, talk about a waste pitch on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
There it is. That's big.
Swung at that pitch.
And he looks at a cold strike three as the cut fastball's in there, and that's out number one. Digging in, Javier Baez. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Ken Giles answers the call from dugout as he'll try to record the final two outs of this one. And that misses ball one.
Come on, Ken Giles.
One and oh pitch on the way. Swung on and missed. 1-1.
I just saw, if you want a new TV, BJ's has one, a 40-inch Samsung for $250.
Runner at first here, one man out. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right hand. That'll move the count to 1-2 now. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Here's the pitch on 2-2. Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now. 3-2. Runners on first with one down. And this is pulled fouled as he was way out front there. The next 3-2. There's a swing and a high pop-up. Panic.
Get there, Panic.
Is there for it.
For you.
And he makes the catch for the second out. Standing in now, the pitcher, Kenny.
Up five? I wonder if Kendra Arias will get first. Two-out magic
here. Eric Young Jr. will be summoned now to be the pinch runner.
Eric Young Jr.
Nowhere close with the fastball to begin the at-bat. It's ball.
I mean, I'll check out the event, but I don't think I'm going to go into it too much. Trying to win 80 games in a week seems dang near impossible.
Looking to hit off the fastball and adjust. That's a pretty good swing.
And you have to be able to play and get the service count to register the wins.
Drive to center field.
That's questionable right now.
Marte.
There we go. Got that damn.
The catch in the ball game is over.
Well, this was a matchup of two regular season teams.
Clap it up, folks. All right. Thank you guys for watching Bullpen Banter. Really appreciate it. The archive will be up on youtube.com/thatsportsgamer. Again, thank you guys for watching. Hit me up on Twitter at thatsportsgamer, youtube.com/thatsportsgamer. And hit that button right here to follow the channel, twitch.tv/thatsportsgamer. And I will be streaming some more throughout the week. We'll be definitely back again next Monday with another hot episode of Bullpen Banter for you. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you again next week. Now it's time for you to get out of the bullpen and get into the game. Thank you for watching, folks.